number 268, question number 7. State the number of lines of symmetry for the following figures. So start with the first one. In the first one, we have the equilateral triangle. So equilateral triangle have all the sides are as equal to the each other. So we are going to draw the line of symmetry here.
First one will be this one. We have three lines of symmetry. Now comes to the second one,
is an isosceles triangle. In this one, two sides are equal to the each other,
this one and this one. So we are going to create the line of symmetry between these two lines again. So this one, so this will have only one symmetry line.
Now comes to the C. In this C we have a scalene triangle. This one, all the sides are different, no side will be equal to the each other, so this will have
no line of symmetry.
Now comes to the part D. In the part D we have a square, all sides are equal to the each other,
so this will have 1, 2, 3 and 4, 4 line of symmetry.
Now comes to the part E. In the part E, this is a rectangle. Now this one is equal and this one is equal to the each other. So
we are going to draw the line of symmetry. This one, so this can have two lines of symmetry.
Now comes to the part F. In this one, we are having a rhombus. All the sides are equal to the each other.
So we are going to create the line of symmetry. So this will have two lines of symmetry.
Now comes to the next part, the part G. This is a parallelogram. In the parallelogram, this one, if we fold this one, we can't get the equal sides. So in this figure, we cannot have line of symmetry. So for the parallelogram, we have
right here no line of symmetry.
Now comes to the quadrilateral. The same one we are having here, we cannot divide it into two parts, so
this will also have no line of symmetry.
Now comes to a regular hexagon. In this one, all the sides are equal to the each other, so we'll create here
1, 2, 3.
So these are the three symmetry lines.
Now we can create more. 4, 5 and this one is the 6. So it will have 6 lines of symmetry.
Now comes to the part J. In this one we are having the circle. So circle,
in this one this is the center. Now from the center we can pass any line through this one. So in the circle we can have infinite symmetry lines. I'm going to write here infinite.
So with this one, we have completed the question number 7. In the next video, we are going to start with the question number 8.